ओके
हेलो हेलो हेलो, वेलकम एवरीबॉडी टू दिस मास्टरिंग चेस एपिसोड 1 विद सोनाली ठक्कर एंड निवेदिता प्रकाशन. सो वी हैव द मोस्ट फेमस इंटेलेक्चुअल एंड हाईली क्रिएटिव पावरफुल वेमेन ऑन द बोर्ड. यस, ओवर हियर.
यस
राइट, वन मोमेंट. वी ऑल्सो हैव निवेदिता योर जस्ट राइट नाउ. वेलकम निवेदिता, आवर स्ट्रीम हैज जस्ट बिगन राइट नाउ 5 सेकेंड्स अगो.
ओह हाय हाय
एंड आई एम
गाइस.
हेल्पिंग टू
ओह
सेट अप
लुक, यू गाइस
जूम
लुक
जस्ट अ
सो
सेकेंड
क्लियर. बाय द
सॉरी द
वे, आई फील
स्क्रीन.
लाइक आई नीड अप माय सिस्टम.
या एंड आई
व्हाट?
एम गोइंग टू शो यू वन मोमेंट. सागर इज हेल्पिंग विथ मी हेल्पिंग मी विथ सम सेटिंग्स राइट नाउ.
It's fine, I understand. I completely understand. When I
Hey,
have
I
Zoom
can.
shows going on, like Aditya is like on standby with like a geo, a router and
I can't
everything.
hear
No, I just
everything, but
moved
I'm
to a new
sure it's
place,
funny
so.
because of Kutaila. No, it's okay.
Oh, where are you?
I'm in Coimbatore.
Oh.
You're in Coimbatore, okay, and she's in Delhi, and I'm in Mumbai. So we
I
three are in
know.
three different cities here.
Correct.
Covering entire India. Yeah.
Yeah.
To south.
Absolutely. Yeah.
Well,
The diversity of chess.
oh, we already have a lot of people there in the chat. Welcome everybody, Aryan, Epsha, Seth. By the way, I want to show you something here. You can see the thumbnail here. Nivedita, are you able to see the screen?
Let's see
Okay,
it.
great.
Yes.
Yes.
Pin that.
You can just pin the screen.
And
She's hanging. Oh, hang on. Hello?
I think Sonali is there.
Yeah, okay,
Yeah,
great.
I did
So,
it. I
can you
did
see the
it. I think I
thumbnail
did it.
and how do you like it?
I love it. It looks great. Look at us with mics.
In your role of comedian, yeah, as a comedian.
That's
Yeah,
what we
exactly.
do.
And that's the reason I'm so excited to teach you guys, and it's going to be a completely new experience here. And what is your take? Like, how are you feeling about learning chess and participating in this Comedians on Board 3?
I'm really glad Samay asked me because, as I told you all before, I have
Yeah.
it. I only play chess with him when I need money from him. So this is my way to like, hey, I'm a good daughter and spend
Super
some time with
Sonali, it's
him.
like playing comedians on board and also beating her father off the board, and I'm sure he's not going to watch this live stream, so this preparation is going to be like a secret preparation.
That's right. My aim is only I've been playing with him for years, okay? और मैं सिर्फ एक बार जीती हूँ. So now
अच्छा.
my aim is to just beat him. I'm gonna go back to Bombay and be like, "Tada, Papa, let's play chess." And he's going to know something's wrong because I have never offered to play more chess. Let's beat him.
That's so cool. That's so cool. And I'm very, very curious because I'm sure you're going to be beating your father in chess, and then whoever your opponent is going to be on Comedians on Board.
Yeah.
And what about you, Nivedita?
I don't know if you know this, but I'm a veteran at these chess tournaments.
One second, is
I've been
this
doing
real
them
or
since they
no?
started. I was on the first one, and my USP on these tournaments is how embarrassingly bad I am at the
Oh.
game.
No. However, I'm sure you can make a lot of jokes out of it, but here, this time, we are
The
going to kill it. Like, absolutely kill it. Show the guys out there. So I'm sure that we are going to improve, and it's the main thing what I see when I was talking to you guys just a little bit, that you guys are very, very interested in chess, and that's the best thing because it's not so easy to get interested in chess, and I think Samai coming in has changed a lot of things already, so this is going to be a lot of fun.
मुझे तो बस अपने बाप को हराना है बस.
Guys, we are going to laugh a lot here. It's not going to be like like any other serious chess stream. This is going to be a lot of fun. I'm already enjoying. By the way, this thumbnail is made by our friend Saif Siddiqui. And we are going to have a lot more interesting thumbnails as well in
the
future.
Let's give it up for Saif Siddiqui, everybody.
Yeah. Okay, so guys, also I need to tell you that both of these are really very famous comedians, and we are also going to ask them a little bit more about their comedy career as well. Like, I think Nivedita, you won the Comicstan, right?
Not Comicstan. I won the OG reality show for comedy called Queens of Comedy.
Okay, and how did you get interested in comedy?
I was just an angry girl who wanted to blow off some steam. And the result of that was some people enjoyed it. So I continued to do it, and it turned out to be a career for me. I didn't plan this.
Wow, that's really great, because I earlier I think there were not many women in comedy, and now it's becoming like a very, very common thing, which is a great thing out there.
Yeah, I think women have a lot to say.
Yeah, I trust you on that. What about you, Sonali? How did it begin for you?
With me, my husband used to do open mics, and I mean, at that time it was not like a career option, it was just like one open mic in a month.
Okay.
So I mean, you would just do it like how, you know, you would do anything, like any activity. Ki is hafte weekend ko bowling kar liya,
yeah.
You know, is hafte picture dekh li, chalo is hafte open mic kar liya. Aise karte karte gaye, but then as and when stage time started increasing, I wanted to do more stage time. I have no idea when I transitioned into doing it full time. I can't say that this was the period, but as and when stage time started increasing.
You entered this field quite late, I would say, because you had to. When did you meet your husband first?
I entered the field 8 years ago, actually.
Okay.
So I think my husband was doing stand-up eight years ago. Yeah, that's when he was doing it.
Okay, 8 years ago. Very nice, I think. And then you entered this field. And I think you guys are CA as well.
Yeah, we are CA. We are child accountants.
Wonderful. So guys, here we are going to have a lot of fun. And what first day we are going to try to assess your chess strength here, or how, whatever you know, whatever you don't know, you have to share it with me. You can already see the board here. And I want to first ask you, do you know the rules of the game?
I know some basic moves.
Uh-huh.
I don't know what I know. I know the white one plays first.
Yeah.
And then the black one. I'm talking like a child now.
That's okay. This is like...
It's called white and black, guys. I don't know. Am I politically correct?
Yeah. It's white and black here. Not racist at all here.
It's African-American black. I don't know what I'm supposed to say.
No.
And the white moves first.
Yeah.
Is it white or is it carrot?
White. White moves first. Ah, you are asking me, Nivedita. Okay. Yeah, okay. So we are going to start from the scratch. Guys, we are going to start from the scratch, and it's going to be a lot of fun, because as we have had a lot of streams earlier, especially on chess, you guys have also told me to do certain things related with basic principles, and I have been also doing some videos on basic principles. So here it's a very, very good way to learn it more. So I'm going to tell you certain things. First of all, this is our chess board here. And we have 32 white squares, you can also call them light squares, and 32 black squares, which are the dark squares. And these are the 8 pieces. Do you know what we call them? Oops, one second. Yeah, let me. Do you know what we call this thing here?
Elephant.
Bishop.
Okay. I'm
no,
going
bishop
to tell you.
Bishop is the camel, no?
Yeah, bishop is the camel.
Yeah.
So these in the corner, they are known as rooks. So correct, elephant actually, in Hindi it's hathi, and in English it's rook, I mean in chess terms. So rook for R. So this is a rook here. Then this is a knight. Yeah, these four.
I love how there are like colloquial terms and then scientific chess terms.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, otherwise it's a ghoda, and you know that Samai says ghoda, respectable ghoda.
Yeah.
Okay. So this is a ghoda and knight in chess terms. Then this one is a, I think you know this, right?
Bishop, right?
What I said.
Yeah, bishop, which was a camel, but we call it bishop in chess. Yes. And this over here?
The queen.
Yeah, this is a queen. Queen, queen you guys would be knowing. Only. Of course, queen you should be.
Queen only.
Yeah. And this one here is, of course, the king. Yeah. Okay. So these are our pieces. Rook, knight, bishop, king, queen. We have five total pieces. And these ones here, you know them?
Pawns.
Yeah, pawns. These are the pawns.
I was scared to say it.
Why?
I don't know. I thought I was wrong. I feel like I'm in school again.
I get that feeling. I get that feeling. Because today when Sagar had a session with Biswa in the afternoon, he was so strict there. And Biswa was so much thinking. And I'm like, what are you doing, Sagar? This is such hardcore training. So I understand. So I'm not going to right now begin like that. It's just our beginning session. We are going to try to understand. So these are the pieces on the board.
Okay.
And here, if you look at the queens here, and if you connect this side, this is called as a queen side. I'll just explain you some terms here, chess terms, because we'll be using those often and you'll be able to understand. Otherwise, it will feel like an alien language when I'm speaking queen side, king side, you know. So, and they are not difficult. They're very simple. So this side here is a queen side. And this side here is a king side.
Okay.
So, yeah. So, that is one more thing.
Just like a bed.
Good one, good one. Yeah. And I'm going to tell you how each piece moves. Or are you aware of that already? You can tell me. We can do the test here.
You can point to the things and ask us and then we'll answer.
Okay, sure. I'll do that.
Yeah.
Yeah. So this is a rook. Do you know how it moves?
Go seedha and like straight and then this way also straight.
Right. So it goes straight. Here you have to tell me if it is white to play, can it go here?
No. I mean, unless there's space in front of it, has to be empty.
Ah, okay. So you know that very well. Yeah. Okay. Tell me how the knight moves.
Two steps and side. Like one, two and this way.
One to this side.
To the side. Yeah, basically it's like, oops.
Yeah.
Yeah. Basically, if I look at it, for example, if it is in the center. Yeah. So two squares, if you look at it straight, just consider the two squares straight and then it will be either of the left or right square here.
Those are my first two moves in any chess game ever. Anyway.
In any chess game. Ever. Yeah.
You know I'm a noob after those moves.
Yeah. Very nice. One second. We have our chat here. A lot of people are watching. 2,000 people are watching here.
What?
Yeah. 2,000 people are watching. Queen in the North, welcome, Mayur, Gurikrit, all these are all our regular viewers. I just, it's been a long time I saw the chat, so I just want to say hi to them. And if you guys can also say hi, it will be very nice.
Hello, thank you for watching the stream, you guys. We're absolute noobs over here, so please be supportive. Don't watch us, be like,
our chat is very, very nice and they are going to be super supportive. So that I trust them, definitely.
Even if they say something mean, we won't be able to see it unless you tell us.
Yeah. Okay. Or if you, one second. Yeah. This is the bishop here.
Okay.
Yeah. This one also you know, but I want to hear from you how it moves.
Diagonally.
What do you agree with her,
Nivedita? Yes, yes.
Absolutely. How have you played chess with anybody before?
So, I played chess twice in my life before Samay got me on the first tournament. And then I played on chess.com with a computer.
Okay,
and
with a computer.
With a computer. And I got 1,000. So I was like, God, I think I'm a prodigy at this. I think I'm really good. And then I went on the tournament. Like, yeah, I'm definitely going to win a piece.
Because I have a computer.
I was like, I won the computer at 1,000 points. And right. That's what I started at, 1,000, like a rating of 1,000.
Right.
And then I played against Abish, who had a really low rating.
Right.
And I was like, I'm going to beat this guy. And he beat me up so easily. Like, I made so many blunders.
But you were not using the computer there?
I was. Look, I was playing against the computer while practicing.
Playing against the computer. Oh, okay. Yeah. So you can adjust his level basically. And that's the reason sometimes the computer also makes a lot of blunders. Because otherwise, do you know something? If you use a computer during the game, then you can be banned.
What?
Yeah, of course. What? If you use the computer while you're playing the game, then obviously it's like a machine is supporting you, right? Mm-hmm. It's going to tell you every right move. It's going to be a perfect move. So you will be automatically banned. Because you know what happens is, let's say it's a 40 move game and you have checked the computer, whatever it suggests, then all of it matches. So it's like the accuracy goes so high and then it's like, okay, you are cheating because you cannot play so well. Right.
I didn't use the computer's help for the moves, but I played against the computer.
You played against.
I'm such a noob, dude. Like when she asked me, "What is your rating?" I'm like, "What is this rating business?" I have no idea. What are they asking?
I know, because I watched the tournaments and I was part of the tournaments. I learned on the job, you guys.
I'm messaging my friends like, what is the score they're asking? And they're like, it's not score, it's rating.
Yeah, it's the rating system where there are these points. There is a FIDE, there is this main organization FIDE where everybody has a rating. So you will see Magnus Carlsen is the highest rated player in the world. So that is how you can compare the strength. More than names, rating will be important.
Whole new world.
Yeah. but you'll get to it very easily, just in 2-3 days. Yeah, so that's going to be okay. Great. So this is the bishop here. Yeah, it moves diagonally. Oops, I'm very sorry. Yeah, it moves diagonally. What am I doing? Okay, I'm a noob in OBS. I'm also going to make some blunders.
This is a noob episode.
So yeah, after like this bishop, if you look at it, it's already on the light color square. And this bishop, if you look at it, it's on the dark color square. So the whole game, this bishop will be controlling only the light squares. Wherever it goes, it will only go on the light color squares. One second.
Yeah.
I need to make a move. Yeah. So whatever, wherever, it's only, it cannot change the colors. So similarly, if one bishop is gone out of the board, then it means your dark squares cannot be controlled by your bishop. So that is what the bishop will do, moves diagonally. And what about the queen?
Queen can go straight and it can have the same rook wala moves and the bishop wala moves.
Yeah, very good, very well, perfect. Exactly, that is how the queen will move. Both the things, rook and bishop, equal to rook and bishop. Yeah, and pawn. We reached the pawn, which is, I would say, the most complicated way it moves. So you tell me.
So the first move is 2 steps. Okay. It kills diagonally. And if it reaches till the end, you can ask for any piece that has died. You can revive it like Mihir.
But here the change is, any piece, even if let's say there is a queen on the board. One second, let me just So even if there is a queen on the board, you can get another queen. So if this is the position and this pawn is moving to the final 8th rank, which is the queening square, then you get a choice. Can you see the options here? Queen, rook, bishop, knight.
Yep.
Yeah, exactly. No, this is not coming on the screen. It won't come on the screen, but you will get an option of, let's say, queen. So you can have two queens at the same time on the board. That's a possibility as well.
Oh, that I don't know.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Oh, I knew that. But what was that thing about you said reviving the piece?
Yeah, that's what. She thought that if there is, if only the queen has died, like it's not on the board already, only then you can get the same piece. But
you can get any piece,
you can get any piece, even if it is on the board. You can get a queen or a rook or a bishop or a knight. It could be any piece, even if it exists on the board already. It doesn't matter.
Got it.
Yeah,
got
you can
it.
Have two queens. If you have seven pawns, you can have seven queens if they are reaching the... The only thing is you need to find them, because many times in this digital thing, it's very easy. The computer will ask, what do you want? But if you're playing on the board, like a proper physical tournament over the board, then it's not easy to find another queen, because in a one chess set, there is only...
Correct. Yeah.
Yeah. That is this thing.
So what do you do when you're playing a physical game? Like, how do you get two queens on the board?
Yeah. So many times when your pawn already reaches sixth rank, you are kind of searching, where is the other queen? And kind of you already take it and are prepared for that, and usually that happens much towards the end of the game, where you have very very low time. It's many times you only have seconds, so you have to be very alert and very quick, and that's
got it.
That makes it interesting, of course. Yeah, so that's about the queen.
I have so many cricket comparisons coming in my head, but I'm like, the chess audience is going to hate.
No. You can definitely give all the comparisons, all the cricket comparisons. In fact, what happens is they are able to very well relate with it, because cricket, everybody understands.
I'm like, the authentic crowd will be like, you're diluting the purity of chess by comparing.
That's what they said when I was playing against Abish. They were just like, they said something in Hindi, something like chess mar gaya or something.
Piece mar gaya. Yeah, you call all the pieces as piece, like piece and pawn. So piece mar gaya. Like if you lose your queen, or if it is, if you lose your bishop or knight, you call it as a piece mar gaya. Right, that's the term which is used. do you know about these? Okay, we were at the pawns. Yeah, so pawn captures, 1 second. You are very right. Pawn captures diagonally.
Right. Is there a move where, like, the pawn goes to the diagonal, it can kill whatever is beside it?
Yes. So that is the final, I'm going to show that to you. It's one of the difficult rules to remember. But 1 second, I'm just wanting to show that. Yeah. All right, can you just see these pawns here?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Yeah, just focus on them. And there is a rule known as en passant. It's a French term, en passant. In India, everybody calls it en passant. So it's okay.
En passant is easier, yeah.
Yeah. I agree, en passant is easier.
En passant is just like, it sounds too nasal. It sounds like lyrics of like some Himesh Keshavya song.
Oh, I think Yashraj Mukhate should make one on up. Sure. Thank you, Sudarshan Rangan, for the super chat. Yeah, so here I want to show you this rule that if black plays... Oops, it's black to play. Okay, maybe I just play one. Yeah, if black goes f5, there is a capture which is very different, which is like e takes f6. Did you understand what happened?
But then I thought it can capture only diagonally.
Right. So a pawn can capture only diagonally, but there is only one exception. And that exception is whenever you have your pawn on 5th rank, let's say you're white. When I say you, it means when white has a pawn on 5th rank and black makes a move which is directly two squares ahead. For example, I want to show you that, just for the sake of understanding, if this pawn was here and now he plays f5, you cannot take here. It doesn't happen. Look, I'm trying, but it's illegal. So that's why the move won't happen.
Oh,
That is the reason it only can work if your opponent is playing two squares. So he's moving his pawn for the first time.
Mm-hmm.
And it's first time, so it has to be two squares directly. Now again, if your pawn was here, okay, and now he plays this. Now there is nothing. Again, it won't happen. If I'm trying, but it won't happen because it's illegal. Or he plays this for the first time, but it's one square. It again won't happen. So it has to be on the side. You see, it's side by side. And yet, it's like, I can just capture it.
I have a question. Sure. If your pawn is on e6, okay. the light one.
Okay, first, I'll make it very easy for us to also communicate in a chess language. So what I'm going to show you is, can you see this A, B, C, D, alphabets?
G.
Yeah. So what we call these vertical lines is, do you know what they are called?
No, I have no idea. Okay. I had no idea they had numbers and alphabets, but now it makes sense.
Yeah, because it's otherwise not possible to give names. Yeah. So these vertical columns, they are known as files in chess terms. Okay. So many times, let's say I'll be telling you, get your queen on the B file or D file. That means I'm trying to tell you to get it on, let's say I say, get your queen on the D file. It means, it's white to play. Yeah. So it means you can get your queen here, which is on the D file.
Got it.
Yeah. So the vertical, the names of the files are A file, B file, C file, D file, E file, F file, G file, and H file. So there are 8 such files on the board, and the rows, it's just like X and Y axis. This is not too technical because if it was very technical, all the time you would have to say it, but that is not what I'm trying to make you do.
Yeah.
It's just that you can communicate better. So I'm letting you know. So these horizontal rows, they are known as ranks in chess terms. So basically, ranks.
Okay.
Yeah. So each rank. So it's the first rank, second rank, third rank, fourth rank, fifth rank, sixth rank, seventh rank, and this is the final 8th rank. So for white side, the 8th rank is here, and if you were black, then the 8th rank would be white's first rank, basically. So it's like that. So it's just like X and Y axis. So now the names of the squares are very easy. If I ask you, this pawn is on which square? So the right answer would be, or you want to attempt, you can try. Let's see.
E5.
Yeah, you're very quick. Amazing. So you have some experience of playing and it's seen. Okay, great.
No, this is like, this is also like an Excel sheet now.
Yeah, way easier to remember. Yeah, right. So this is E5. Now I'll ask you, where is this square where the queen exists?
D2.
Right. And if in notation terms, let me go back. Yeah, now I play this. What will you call this move as?
Sliding.
That is amazingly funny. I like it.
the queen moved to the G file.
Yeah.
Perfect. No, but yeah. I like that joke better. Yeah, this is queen G5 here. So that is the reason when I tell you about the pieces. One second. No reset. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. So if you look at the board, so whenever I say a piece goes to a square, the notation in chess form will be considered as, let's say if I play this move, then I will say knight f3. Because it's the knight. Now knight f3, how do I write? Actually, when we play the tournaments, we write it as nf3 because k is for the king. And hence, N is for the knight here. So it's like knight F3. rook g1 if the rook is on g1. So it's that is the way you can let me know that I want to play knight e5 and I'll make a move here. Like,
guys, I just need to get it out of my system that every time you say rook, it goes rook, rook, rook. Arey baba, rook in my hand. I just want to get it out of my system. Because every time you say it, it's just playing in my head.
No, I agree with you completely because it has happened to me. But I'm so glad that you can make a lot of jokes related with it.
I just had to get it out of my system and now it's out of my system so we can focus on the game.
No, no, but why do you have to get it out of your system? It's nice, you know, it's rook, rook, rook. Yeah. You will try to make your rook very active.
I didn't know rooks had a thing for taboo, man.
Oh, this is really fun. I'm going to tell Sagar that I have had the best stream. Like, this is a killing stream. I'm going to learn a lot of comedy from you.
So, I had a question, basically. When the pawn was on, if it comes to e6, right? If it comes to e6, then the black pawn can have take it. If it... agar wo wahan tak ho, to phir... अगर पॉन हिला ना हो अपनी मेन जगह से तो फिर वो ही कैन किल द वाइट वन राइट
यूर लाइक इन दैट सेम पोजीशन वन सेकंड सो दैट आई विल अंडरस्टैंड
इफ द ब्लैक वन इज इन
या आई एम जस्ट सेटिंग अप या दिस वाज अ पोजीशन
हां और अगर ये एक और आगे जाए इफ इट गोस टू ई6 देन द ब्लैक वन कैन किल
या या एब्सोल्युटली ही कैन किल बाय आइदर ऑफ द पॉन He can take got it, by the D pawn or by the F pawn. And in notation, what we say when a capture happens, basically this is an exchange. There's a capture. So in notation, we say D takes E6. D takes E6. So that is how we say. F takes E6. And when we write it as D into. So many times it's like sometimes... While speaking, it's like D into E6. But the right way to say is D takes E6. Yeah.
Got it.
And do you know the general value of the pieces?
Matlab, like in terms...
If I have to ask you to give points to the rook, knight, bishop, queen, and a pawn. Like out of 10.
Papa mujhe ek baar bola tha. queen is 10 on 10.
Queen is who said I couldn't understand? Huh? Who said?
Sorry.
Saloni, you said. Sonali, you
said. I think queen is 10 on 10.
Okay, that's what you think.
Because she's.
Nivedita, do you know it already? That's
pawn.
What.
No. You are also. Pawn is 2 points.
Ah, okay. Pawn. You are thinking 2 points. What do you think about the queen? Are you in the same?
I think queen should be 10 points.
Queen is 10 out of 10. Okay, what about the rook? I'm going to tell you the appropriate points later at the end. First, I want to hear what do you think. What about the rook?
I think rook is rated higher than a bishop.
Okay.
Now, this is how I'm going to rate.
Nice.
Process of elimination.
That is true.
Horse is higher than bishop, less than rook.
Okay.
I'm guessing. King is useless.
Oh, it's like I'm gonna play the game of chess, but king is useless. sounds great. Queen 10 out of 10, king useless. I like it.
Pawn, I guess, is important, but there are so many of it, so sabko ek ek point mil jata hai.
Sabko ek ek point, matlab, okay. So, yeah, you were quite close, I would say, actually. Queen is 9 points, the value of the queen. Rook is 5 points.
Who's judging them? Indian Idol judges. Who's judging them? These points. Farah Khan is like, sorry, queen, you don't have the X factor. I cut 1 point.
He'll have the some Persian Darbar kind of judges there. Rook, 5 points. Bishop is 3 points. And knight is also 3, though it can be 2.5 to 3, something like that. It depends on the position. And pawn is 1. Of course, this value of the pieces is just to understand that, you know, it means that you would never like to exchange the queen with the bishop because bishop is 3 points and queen is 9 points. So definitely much stronger than bishop. That is for that reason.
Or king ka kya hai?
Yeah, king is not useless, but now I'm going to ask you, do you know what is a checkmate?
Yeah.
Yeah. Can you explain what is a checkmate?
When the king is cornered because it's useless.
Oh, that expression for a checkmate, it is epic, absolutely epic.
That's the expression for checkmate. Checkmate is when you keep moving your king one step and when your father keeps following you. Checkmate. checkmate. That is checkmate for me.
I don't know. I have to, I will have to tell Samay that I don't know if I can teach because I'm just enjoying this. I'm just laughing and I'm loving the jokes. So I'll have to be really serious. This is funny. Yeah, absolutely. King, basically, if it gets a check is, by check, I mean that any piece, let's say, let me show you the shortest mate, f4, e6, g4, and now there is a mate in one for black. Like black makes one move and it's a checkmate. Can you find it?
Yes.
Oh, that's
I
great.
Think I see it. Ah, I see the queen. The black queen.
Okay, maybe you know the answer. Maybe we give 10 seconds. Maybe we give 10 seconds for
it's a check or checkmate.
Yeah, it's a check. And whenever you give a check and the king cannot move anywhere, that time it's a mate.
Correct.
Yeah. So she has already given a... Nivedita is going to guide you for this.
Yeah, please guide me.
I mean, I think you just have to look at the black queen and see the only place it can move to.
But it black... can only move... Oh, got it.
So now you have to give a check, and she Nivedita said with a queen. So there is a check with this queen, with the black queen. Basically, it will attack the white king.
Got it.
And the white king will have no square.
I think it has happened to me.
पापा ने किया रहेगा पापा ने किया रहेगा
मैंने किसी और के साथ खेला ही नहीं है डेफिनेटली हो चुका है मेरे साथ ये एंड आई थिंक आई कैन हिज लाफ्टर इज रिंगिंग इन माय इयर्स सडनली
ओह नाइस ओके सो शैल वी आस्क निवेदिता
या क्वीन टू h4
राइट Did you, were you able to now see the square, Sonali?
Yeah, I saw it. Yeah.
Queen
H4, got it. Yeah.
And why this is a checkmate? Because
he can't move.
Yeah, these squares are occupied. This one is controlled by the queen, and this one is also controlled by the queen, and that's the reason it's checkmate. So, but I want to ask you one change here. Let me make the change. Okay. Now, if this is the position, the question is Queen H4 a checkmate? The same last move, is it a checkmate?
No.
No, because then he can, then the horse can move and then they'll have a check, right?
Yeah. No, they don't have a check, but if you give a check, the horse, what do we call that?
Knight.
Yeah. No, it will take some time. First day, it's okay. But knight g3, and then you can see that the check has been dealt with by bringing some other piece in between. So, this is one more way to deal with checks, by bringing your pieces or pawns in between, and the check is gone. Okay, I'm going to ask you one more question. So your queen h4, is it a checkmate?
Queen h4? No.
No.
No, because a knight can take the queen.
Yeah, absolutely. Queen h4 is not a checkmate. Oops, maybe I did white play.
I feel like I'm learning algebra, you know, in tuition.
The x-axis and y-axis.
the whole square, it's 2 AB.
Yeah.
I'm remembering it. Oh shit, oh shit.
Yeah, no, it's
But
just like x and y-axis. Absolutely, that's.
I actually do have a question about the points. So, what are the points for? Do they decide who wins
No, no.
if the time goes up or something?
So the game is decided by only one thing, one and only thing. It's about the king. If the king is checkmated, it's over. That's all. The value of the pieces is for the sake of understanding, so that when you're playing, like right now, I know that I cannot just give my queen free like this because I just, lost one of the most effective pieces.
Got
So
it.
that is only for exchanges, which I'll of course come to, which you will understand. But imagine right now, let's say you had to play a move like, yes, this knight is on h4, yeah, instead of the queen. So if you had to put the knight on h4, this looks okay because even if white captures a knight, when knight takes knight, queen takes knight, it's still like an equal exchange, right? So it's mainly you can say to understand something like a barter system or something like that. It's like I give you something which is of one value, you will give me of equal value, something like that. But in
Got
chess, there are a lot of exceptions. We'll come to that. But this is the beginning. We need to understand that these are the important things to know.
God.
Yeah. So that was the check. We could bring something in between. We could capture the piece which was giving the check. That, or we can of course move the queen, king if there is place. That is how we react to a check. Okay. Let's 1 second. Reset. Let me give you some positions. Do you know how to mate with a queen? Let us try that, okay?
I'm such a noob. I'm laughing at all these jokes that y'all must have already
Okay,
laughed
no,
at in
you got a new joke in your
the
mind, yeah?
past. It's like, does anybody know how to mate with
Mate with
the queen? Oh God!
I'm such a child, dude.
No, both of us thought the same thing. I
Yeah,
was just
she
fine.
just thought that, okay, I'm not going to say that Nivedita said to
Everybody hide the queen.
herself. Okay. Nice. So, no, really, I like it's like for us, it's like lot of I now that I think of lot of such things will come to my mind, but better that I have.
Yeah, like if I was learning chess at like 12 now, and my the teacher would have been like, does anybody know how to mate with the queen? I can imagine the whole class going,
Okay. Yeah. All right. So you have another 10, 15, 10 to 15 minutes, yeah, guys? Yeah,
Okay, all
10,
right.
10, maybe 10 minutes or something. Okay. So you're white to play. What we'll do is, Nivedita, you try to defend with black.
Sorry, I didn't hear you. I missed you over there.
Okay, but this with whatever is available right now
Yeah. So
with the
I'll.
three pieces.
Yeah. So of course this is
Okay.
all lost.
Sorry, I didn't hear you.
Ah, okay. So Nali, can
You
you hear
dropped
me
out for
now?
me.
Yeah.
Yeah, I can hear
Yeah. Now I can. I said
you.
we'll have the stream for another 10 minutes or so, right? Yeah. So there's a queen mate. So what I'm trying to say is Nivedita will try to defend because Nivedita has already played in comedians earlier. So that's the reason she'll
Okay.
try to defend, and we will see how you are going to mate, like how long it will take for you. All right.
All right.
So Sonali, you can tr start with white 1 second, and you can tell me the moves.
So I have to protect the king, basically, right?
You have to checkmate this black king. Checkmate.
Checkmate the black
Yeah, so
king.
you have to do it with this white queen. Basically, as we know, that
Okay.
it's going to be a check, and the king won't be able to move at the end.
Right.
So how can you do that?
I'll move it to one. I'll move it to A2.
A2. So you are trying to give a check from here. Yeah, Nivedita, where you?
And I'll move the king to E or D6.
Okay. Your move.
I'll move it to A3.
A3. Okay.
I'll move it back to E6.
Okay.
Isn't it okay? Can I move it to? I mean, if I keep going back and forth, then it's wahi hota rahega, right?
Yeah, and then you know, if you get the same position thrice, as a rule, it will be a draw.
So I'll move it to A. One second, if you do the same move thrice, if you get to the same position thrice.
Yeah, so it's like queen A2. If I go again, she goes king D6 again. You give a check again. And here it's the third time I played queen A2. So it
got it. A6.
Yeah, so now she played. You had played this. She played this. And now you are giving A6. You have found a new check. So you don't want a draw. Okay.
Yeah. क्या किंग किंग को मार सकता है क्या
नहीं 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 आई डिडंट टेल यू हाउ द किंग मूव्स राइट हाउ डम्ब
आई मीन हां एक 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 स्टेप जाता है लेफ्ट राइट
राइट इट गोस
दैट आई नो दैट्स व्हाई आई सेड ही इज यूजलेस
सो किंग कैन गो हियर बट इन दिस केस ओनली वन एक्सेप्शन दैट इफ देयर आर टू किंग्स इन फ्रंट ऑफ ईच अदर they cannot directly come on next to the adjacent square. So I cannot play this move here, king e5. It will be illegal because the square is already controlled here. You can say something like that. Yeah.
Right.
Yeah. So this is a check. Nivedita has to play.
Yes. e7.
King e7.
King e7.
Yeah.
Or if I take it to like a d6, then she can kill me with it, right?
Yeah, if you give
got
a check,
it, got
yeah,
it.
There is no support to this.
Got it. Okay.
So that's the reason may want to support the square.
I may want to support the square. Like with the, can I move the king then first to like an e5?
Yeah, very nice, very nice. King e5. Okay, Nivedita, please.
I will move to king f7.
King f7.
I would move it. So then if I move now the queen to e6, then it's a support, right?
Yeah. He cannot take your queen because the king is supporting. Though the king cannot go on that square directly, but it can support, yeah.
Matlab, main nahi samjhi.
Matlab, if here you cannot take your king to, e6. This is illegal. Uh-huh.
Correct.
Right? But any other piece is coming there. Now he cannot capture this because this king is.
Got it. Yeah. Okay. So then I'll move. Is it my turn?
Sorry, you played queen e6 check.
Yeah.
It's my turn. It's I move to g7.
Yeah.
I'll move the king to f5.
Okay. So you are cornering the king already.
I'll move my king to f8.
F8.
Mm, I'll move the king to f6.
Okay.
Oh god. I move my king to g8.
Can you go there?
Oh, I can't go there.
Why can't she go there? Because of the castling thingy?
No, because of the queen. The queen will get me.
It's illegal because the queen is... So you can see already, let's look at this queen, okay? So
then it's checkmate. She's got me, right? Then.
But where is the check? I mean, where is the check?
One more move, I guess.
No, but how? So this is a...
Because any move I make now, I'm cornered. So if I move to the sides, she's got me with the queen. If I move diagonally, she's got me with the king. So can I still... Oh, I can't move there because the king has power over that square.
Yeah, and I'm going to laugh here because this is really funny. And this one of the stream which Samay had at that time, I think Mithpat and this triggered Insan, I think they had a match. And it ended in exactly the same thing, which I'll explain you right now. This situation is called as a stalemate.
Oh!
Stalemate, that's right.
You know
I've heard this term.
I don't know the stalemate.
I have heard this term.
Yeah, and now you will know what it means. So basically...
It's a very unfortunate result.
Unfortunate for white. I mean, it's a good result for black. Because if you look at it, there is no check and the king cannot move. And that's the reason it's called as a stalemate. But... If let's say you could go, white to play. Yeah. If let's say I go here, you go here. That's the only square. You go here, wherever the king goes. And now the king cannot move, but there is also check. So this is an actual checkmate. And so basically when you had a queen here, what you did was exactly give a few checks. Then you realize that, no, I need to, you know, push the king away. So otherwise there is no mate. Yeah, he has a lot of squares here. So you gave a check here. Now she was pushed back to the next this thing. And then you got your king. Yeah. So this is the right approach. You must try to push the king to the corner, any corner of the board. But also avoid check stalemates. But that's a funny rule, in chess. Yeah,
that means I made a good move.
Absolutely, because king f6, the last move she played was a very obviously you will think of that move first. It's not like, oh my god, what did you play? Like, it's something naturally somebody will think of it. Oh, now I want to take my guess. So it was a good move what you played.
Sweet. This increased my confidence in chess.
This is your?
What? This stream has increased my confidence 10 lives. 10 lives.
Yeah.
I have reached a point of chess which I have only heard in myths. I thought stalemate was an urban myth.
Oh my god, I'm very happy to hear this. 10 times your confidence has increased. I cannot imagine what we are going to do in the next streams. I think we are going to kill it, definitely. But it was a very good start for us to... I understood, what all... where we stand and what all we need to work upon. So I'm going to prepare accordingly for our next session, I would say. Now that I understand you both well and we have connected, it's very interesting. Let's do more things. Let's play chess. Let's analyze it. And it's going to be fun. And I have enjoyed. Yes. I have laughed. And you guys are super awesome because really it's my first stream with... Like I have always done, but always with Sagar somewhere in the Zoom call or myself or something like that. But with you guys for my first stream, you really made me feel very comfortable. So thank you so much for that.
And you make us feel comfortable, like...
Exactly, yeah.
Oh, that's really nice to know. But so...
thank you so much. I had so much fun. This is like my first chess stream, guys. I'm like... Super excited about this.
Yeah, guys, and follow these guys. They are also on Instagram. I think we'll also, next time I'll also put their links so that you will be able to know them.
Haan, guys, Instagram pe please follow kar dena.
And yeah, we have a super chat from Scale Tail. This time COB3 will be of another level. Excited for it. All the best to you both. Chess OP hashtag.
Thank you. I hope I beat a beach this time. So I'm
Oh, that will be a revenge match. That will be interesting. Yeah.
No, it's always been between Abish and I, and he always beats me at it.
Okay, are you expecting this time also it will be the same opponent, or what do you think?
I just feel like they'll do it on purpose.
Nice. That if that happens, it will be great. I'll be very excited for the revenge match.
Because when I asked Samay, am I going to be fit against Abhish again, he started laughing hysterically.
And then you're trying to understand the psychology. Ah, this laughter, what does it mean here? Awesome. And what about you, Sano? I'm messing up with Saloni.
I'll tell you what all names I've got, okay, in my entire life. Sonali, Saloni.
Yeah.
My mother keeps auto-correcting my name to Somali. So it is, I've got all names across the board. Mera naam kisi ko yaad hi nahi reh raha hai.
No, I have to find a shorter nickname for you both. Or maybe you can also suggest. Niv, yeah?
Yeah, Niv is... Or Nivi, whatever you want to.
Niv.
I just love how you're like, I can't remember your name. You change your name.
You change your name.
But that's the story of my life. People would like give me just random names because they don't want to say my name. People have called me Nikita.
What?
And I'm like, why? Yeah, why are you calling me Nikita? It's like, Nikita's too
That's
hard.
The big step.
Yeah,
that's
leap from Nivetta.
Yeah. And that is no relation. Yeah. At least Saloni, yeah, Sonali, I think there is something, you know, it's like a fair this thing.
Yeah, I'm like, if you're going to mess up the name, just own it. Just say Saloni. Just say it. Just get it out of your system. Don't be like Saloni. You're making
yeah.
So like, I knew you're gonna mess it up.
Yeah. So I'm gonna call Nivedita Niv, and Sonali, you tell me, what can I call you?
Whatever, I'm okay with anything.
What did he say, Niv?
Son. Your son.
That's exactly what my dad wanted to.
My son.
Son. Yeah, that is interesting. I'll call you son. Okay, that's done. Okay. That's done. We are prepared for our next dream.
Damn, son!
Cool. All right. Oh, Devin, very nice to see you here. We have one of our viewers who is a musician from Australia, and he's watching the stream. So.
Wow. Wow. Hey. Yeah. We have an international audience.
Yeah, a lot of people from a lot of different countries follow, because now chess in lockdown became really popular also thanks to Samay, basically. So yeah, it's a lot of fun because we feel connected somewhere, like a social, it's like a social thing here, because otherwise you don't get out of your house.
That's true.
Yeah. All right.
I'm saying that's true while I'm in Delhi.
Okay, so guys, thank you so much for being there and being such a nice audience, you know, really being full time and seeing how they are progressing and learning. It has been a lot of fun. So thank you, Sonali, Sun and Niv, for being here and for taking so much interest in chess. Next stream, we are going to share more stories. I'm going to ask you more questions of chess and other than chess as well. So let's catch up next time. Thank you, everybody.
Yes. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Nice. Yes. Thank you. Guys, Instagram pe follow kar dena.
I'm just going to end it here.